Looky. It's dripping. The faucet is dripping. So we need to repair it. This simple laundry faucet. First thing we do, we follow our supply line and see if there's any shutoff valves. There is shutoff valves, but they shut off the hoses that go to the washer, to the laundry machine. So we have to follow this further up. And then, as you see, up there are two valves that we have to close. So let's do that quick. It's a little tough. So it must be a high quality valve because it's still working well. There, this and this both are closed. And then we can open those faucets and the water should drain out. Our next thing is to take the handles off. There's a Phillips screw on this side. And we see this here, there. And there's one Phillips screw on this other side. Let's take this out of the way. There's one here. Look at that. So we need a Phillips to work on those. PH2 it's called. If you lose those little screws here, see the screw I took out, oh, if that falls into your sink, into the hole, it's gone. So if you put something over the hole, it cannot fall apart. You can just pull this off and you can't see it from there. I do the same thing on this side here. Comes out pretty easy. If the handle doesn't come off easy, you can use a screwdriver to pry it loose. And now our next step is to remove those seats. Okay, and I'm gonna see, we need the right tool for it. So I found out that 5/8 is the right size. We take those off. So this one came out pretty easy. There is a rubber gasket here, and in my case I don't have to be careful with this water leaking out, because that is a laundry sink, so that is okay. Yeah, so now we see here those seals. Again, we have to take the Phillips out, and then we can use our 5/8 to hold this. Let me take out this little screw here. Hope that the little GoPro camera shows this right. Now we can use a little pick tool to get the seal out, the old rubber. It says flat washer bag, 1/4 L flat washer bag. It cost about $1 at the Ace store. If you buy this in bulk, most likely much cheaper than regular flat washer. Okay, goes in here. So you see there's some writing on it. On this side, the writing goes in first.
Okay. And then we put the screw back in here. Tool. There it is. And then it can go back in here. Like this, and we're happy. We need to repeat the same on the other side. Out. We do use our little pick again. Look at the old rubber gasket out, and then it's the same thing. Don't poke your finger. Again, there's a name on there, so the name is a little embossed there. So we put that in first so that we have a flat surface here. This thing doesn't want to go in sweet and smooth. At the end, when you close it up, it will push it in all the way. Okay, so let's get that screw back in. Here. Now, what can happen is that you break this screw. There's always a chance. Unless you see, I didn't. Look, this one goes all the way in. Let's put that back in here. Now we have to put our handles back on in the straight position. This one here also straight position. There it goes. And then those screws have to go back in. One here and one here. You're going to have to tighten them. Yeah, I'm going to start on this side first. There. And here. Open it up a little bit, just a little here. We take our piece over here, and then I'm opening the main water supply again. Very nice. Now we turn the water off on both sides. It's gonna stop leaking. Close. Whoa, a little air. See that I have a good pressure here, right? How do you like that?
No, it stops dripping.
See how it stops dripping?
Yep, that was an immediate quick fix. All right, so I thank you guys for watching this video. And I hope I see you soon in one of my other videos.